They say imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, but who knew it could also play a role in treating autism?
The disorder affects hundreds of thousands of families around the U.S., but ongoing studies and research are giving them hope.
And some of that research is happening right here in mid-Michigan. In tonight's special report, how MSU is using imitation to help children with autism be more engaged.
Red.
Toni Randall and her five-year-old son Jonah play like this every day.
He is a very energetic little boy. He's very affectionate, just a special, sweet little boy.
Jonah is autistic, on the more severe end of the spectrum, Toni says. He doesn't speak, but he sure does smile. They're not having fun at home today. They're at the Michigan State University Autism Lab doing a training exercise in imitation. It's one of several studies Assistant Professor Brooke Ingersoll is conducting. This one in particular was recently published in the Journal of Autism and Developmental Disorders. Ingersoll's findings suggest young children with autism who learn to imitate show improvements in a range of social skills.
I think these are really promising results. By increasing imitation, we can improve that social interaction, and hopefully we can also improve their ability to learn from their environment.
Not only that, the children in the study also improved in joint attention, which is the ability to share attention between a person and an object.
This is a particular behavior that we know is one of the earliest markers of ASD in young children and is one of the more sort of autism-specific deficits that we see. And it's one of the skills that is particularly resistant to treatment.
So how do they do it? Simple exercises that Ingersoll says parents can do with their children at home.
Teaching parents to imitate their child's play. So getting down on the floor, getting near where their child is, and imitating what the child is doing, what they're doing with the toys, what they might be doing with their body, what they might be, gestures they might be using, sounds or words they might be using.
Jump.
In 5 minutes here, 10 minutes there, during daily interactions.
Yes, good job.
It's worked for Jonah.
He has actually dramatically improved.
He didn't participate in the actual study, but his mother says he's benefited greatly from the results.
He has responded really well to the imitation. He really enjoys seeing others act like he does. It kind of engages him more with other people. He's more interactive, so it's been wonderful.
For Ingersoll, it's a step in the right direction. Progress in the field of autism research.
We're getting a better idea of what autism looks like in the first year of life, in the first 2 years of life, and the better idea we have of what it looks like, the better idea we have of the best ways to treat it.
Ingersoll is currently working on a similar study on imitation in adolescents with autism. If your child is on the autism spectrum and you'd like to get involved with the research happening at the MSU Autism Lab, call 517-432-8031. We will also put that contact information on our website. Just look for this story at WILX.com later tonight.